the overcast, cold day, many hundreds of people see the arrival of King Edward at Broadcasting House London. His Majesty is received by Mr. R.C. Norman, Chairman of the Board of Governors, and Sir John Reith, Director General of the Corporation. From Broadcasting House, the King's voice will be heard throughout the world. It is his first broadcast as the King. Punctually at 4 millions, listen.
It has been an ancient tradition of the British monarchy that the new sovereign should send a written message to his peoples. Science has to make that written message over the radio. This, however, is no innovation. For my father has, for the last few years, spoken to his peoples at Christmas time. Little more than 2 months ago, he broadcast his last Christmas message, and to many of you, the sound of his voice must still seem to be ringing in your ears. He was speaking then at the close of a long and wonderful reign, which covered a period of 25 years, during which unprecedented changes had taken place, and great anxieties and problems have been shared by all. I feel that his death is not only an overwhelming grief to my mother and to us, his children, but that it is at the same time also a personal loss to you all. It is wonderful for us to know how universally my father's great qualities have been appreciated and valued. It now falls upon me to succeed him and to carry on his work. I am better known to most of you as the Prince of Wales, as a man who, during the war and since, has had, and although I now speak to you as that same man, who has that experience, and whose constant effort it will be to continue to promote the well-being of his fellow men.
Ce rallye, qui est exclusivement réservé aux femmes, comprend différentes épreuves: vitesse, maniabilité et endurance. Le départ est donné à Orly et les vaillantes sportives s'élancent vers la Côte d'Azur. Mais la course est plus difficile qu'on ne le croit généralement. Une concurrente en panne se fait remorquer et passe devant le célèbre Arc de Triomphe d'Orange. Le pont de Beaupas sur le Rhône.
Après la vraie course.
Madame Dubuctaine, qui sera une des lauréates du classement général. Madame Liévin sur licorne sera première de sa catégorie. Et enfin, Saint-Raphaël, le soleil et la mer.
Dans Strasbourg, soucieuse mais calme, les troupes ont parcouru la ville pour accompagner le général Gamelin au cimetière de Cronenbourg, où tant de combattants de la Grande Guerre reposent. Notre généralissime a tenu, avant de présider les assises des souvenirs français, à saluer la mémoire de ceux que la France n'oublie pas. Après ce pieux pèlerinage, le général Gamelin a retracé vigoureusement devant ses auditeurs le vrai visage de la France forte, calme, consciente de son droit.